the end of another day of auditions. It's been a really, really good day. And we've still got a few actors to see, which is really exciting. I've got my mate Damien, Damien McFarlane, who I was at school with, coming in soon. He's a wonderful young actor. That's really exciting. Speak of the devil, just had a little text from Damien, probably giving me a few warnings before he gets it. He sent a video, actually, so just give that a...
Alex, hi, it's Damien. As you can see, I'm stuck in a dingy basement in Soho doing some ADR. Devastatingly, it means I'm not going to be able to make it in.
Oh,
I thought I could send in a self-tape. And listen, mate, hopefully my acting is so impressive that I almost, Come out the screen! Come out the screen! Sorry, there were two doors.
Now, what do you know about Petrichor?
Well, I know I want to destroy it.
To destroy the film?
Bring it down.
Bring it the film down?
Yeah, patriarchy.
The patriarchy? No, it's patriarchy. No, it's Petrichor.
Small step right.
You're my right.
In frame. The window's right, really. So forward, yeah. So it's
okay.
And I'll just get that.
Yeah, just so I know it's raining right in the scene, just so I know what I'm hearing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's raining and you just come in as Oscar and I'll be reading Arthur.
Okay. Come on in. Sorry, I've just woken up, as you can see by my pajamas. Sorry, who's reading?
I'm so sorry, Damien. I just saw a tweet actually, just from the Donmar warehouse, just saying they've got a new season coming up, which is quite exciting, isn't it? I'm just thinking, it'd be a shame for you to miss that because you were playing Oscar.
Oh no, I've spoken to my agent. I'm really spending this year focusing on film and TV. So yeah.
Oh, fine. Sorry.
So we're outside Chloe's house. She's a mate of my cousin's. As you can see, it's an absolutely stunning property. So my plan is I go in, chat to her, make her the locations manager of the film. Basically though, I just get the free use of the house as a location. So what could possibly go wrong? Actually, stop, sorry, because then that's when it always cuts in a film, isn't it? To like me in a sewer or something, or me like with my pants down, getting hit by a club. So I'm not gonna say that, I'm gonna say I'm going to walk over there now, and then how could that go wrong? See? I've dodged a bullet there. Simple. Fuck's sake.
Come on in. Sorry, I've just woken up. As you can see by my pyjamas.
Adam was actually... You were reminding me earlier that they're doing another season of Peaky. Blinders, which I just got distracted, so I just think it'd be so...
I've actually straight out of drama school, one line in it, first job, so I can't do it again. But you're right, no, I would be good for it, but what can I do?
Okay, well, that's fine then. That's completely clear. No worries. Let's do it.
Yeah, okay.
Sorry, hit me again with the line.
Come on in, sorry, I've just woken up.
Isn't Richard Curtis doing another film? I think he is. I think he probably is. I think he probably will be writing another one.
Hello, my name's Chloe Strindberg, and Alex has kindly invited me to be location scout, location person, which I'm really excited about because I love the arts, I love Disney films, that sort of thing. And it's a really great role because it's like being paid to go on holiday. So it's...
Sorry, it really, Chloe, yeah. Just, you know, it's... location, it's not a paid position.
No. Yeah, no,
just
obviously.
To clarify. Sorry to interrupt. Yeah, and it's on in terms of it's, holiday. It's yeah. It's, we're probably keeping things probably in London.
London,
just for ease.
Great, but no, I'm really excited about being location scout because you get to be in London.
Okay, well, yeah, get the script, let's have a go on its feet. Let's give it a run
through.
Yeah,
just before we start, I have to run everything through my American agent. It's just how I work, and she likes to see everything before I do it, so contract, script, everything like that.
Of course, that's absolutely fine. It's worth saying, maybe, like, it's a completely UK-based production, so there's not, if you're worried about, like,
I
American...
I know, it's just how she works,
American agent. That's fine, isn't it, Adam? Yeah, absolutely. We'll get a phone call over to them, what are we doing, like, Are they on East Coast or West Coast time?
She's actually South Coast, so she's based in Bournemouth.
So when you say your American agent, you mean just an agent who is American?
Yeah, my American agent. Yeah.
But they live here. They live in
yes.
Britain.
Yeah, but she's American.
Right.
My American agent.
Let me tell you a bit about the kind of location we're after
our
sort of main our main location.
Yes.
We're looking for a house, a home, a domestic environment.
Okay.
And the key note for us really is somewhere that feels a bit artistic.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe a little bit kind of eclectic in design.
Ah, great.
Somewhere that's maybe got like period features, maybe a mantelpiece. So maybe it's like a house that's got a lot of art on display.
Oh, okay.
Maybe it's somewhere that quite eccentric. Something like, you know, some butterflies in a Perspex box. You know what I mean? That kind of
sounds
place.
Silly. Yeah. And there's quite a few. I mean, there are houses near here that aren't dissimilar to that.
Yeah.
So
next.
Hi guys.
Oh no. Sorry. No, not right at all.
Okay. Thank you.
When you know, you know. Right, who's next?
Well, there's no one for a while.
Can we get him back?
Fuck's sake.
A second. Why don't I just count to three?
Okay.
And then when I've done that, you just say the first thing that comes into your head, the first place that you can think of that might be what I'm after. So, one, two, three.
55 Ringham Road. Oh, no, that sank.
My voice is kind of at this range, so I'm not going to be able to go, this. And, like, it kind of... I can't go any lower than that.
We won't. You know what? We're not going to need you to go lower than that, I don't think.
That was in Sussex. There was a sinkhole.
So bear in mind, we're looking more somewhere in London, somewhere ideally that you know you have a bit of an in with.
It's completely underground now, so that's off. Unless you don't want dark, pitch black. You don't want to go down to the house.
No, we're looking for somewhere much more
that hasn't sunk.
And I can't go higher than this.
You know, it's the middle, that middle range is kind of the territory we're going to be in for the just normal speaking.
God, it's a shame.
I suppose, though, even just somewhere that's, you know, even pretty near here.
Yes.
That had the kind of thing I'm after. Can you?
There's a cafe near here. That could be good to ask in the cafe.
So the crew are in place, cast are almost in place, and Chloe may not have got the hint about using her house as the location, but it's no big deal, because she's actually found us somewhere that looks like a really good alternative, and it's only like 90 quid a day, so easily under budget. We're going in now to meet up with the location liaison officer, who's gonna show us around. So let's do it. I think that's him there, is it? Stuart? Hi, Stuart, it's Alex.
Oh,
hey. Hey, good to meet you.
Yeah, good
hello,
to meet
pal.
You too.
All right, so, of course, this is the location.
Yeah, oh, this is the property, yeah.
Location property, yeah, perfect.
Well, cross wires, basically, because it turns out Stuart wasn't a location's liaison officer. He was just an estate agent showing us around a normal flat.
No pets, yeah, I think it's anything they've made it clear to me.
Oh, sorry, one thing just while I remember.
Yep.
What's the state of play with toilets? Are they on site?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Really?
There's two toilets here. You got one downstairs and one upstairs.
Oh, fantastic. You haven't got to book a port-a-loo separately?
No. Has it been? No, there's two toilets here, yeah.
Oh, great. Yeah. That's cool. Because I was looking, I thought you probably could get a port-a-loo in down there, but you don't think it's necessary.
Definitely don't need to. I mean, you could if you wanted to, I guess.
So there are two toilets upstairs, sort of like male, female type thing?
I know, they're just sort of, you know, unisex.
Yeah. Yes. Why prescribe? Like, picking back over it now, I think the main problem was that the first time I heard the phrase locations liaison officer was when I said it.
And as you saw on the website, you know, you get loads and loads of light through here in the morning.
Oh, okay.
Which is,
do you?
But we'd be cool to just black all the windows out, yeah?
Yeah, you could do if you want to, yeah.
Great. Yeah, we would do. We'd just completely black out the windows and hang loads and loads and loads of lights up there just to kind of recreate that morning feel.
Right, yeah. Otherwise, I'd say you get it in the morning.
Exactly, yeah, so we'd just get them blacked out. Perfect.
So the upshot is, instead of hiring a location for a 3-day shoot, we have rented a 4-bed flat in Enfield for 6 months. You think what I'm thinking, Adam?
Go on.
Well, look, this could actually work really well as the science lab.
Oh, great.
I would have to check about doing sort of experiments or anything like that.
Oh, yeah, of course. No. It would all be pretend experiments. Yeah. Just as long as it looked right, sort of smoke and bubbles and stuff, it would all be, yeah. What's weird is that looking back over it now, there were no real clues that it wasn't a filming location.
Actually, Adam, there's going to be loads and loads and loads of wires coming down either side, so it'd be good to make a note of that, just like...
Okay, yeah. Otherwise, right, yes, no, I see now, okay.
Exactly, that's why we'll block it all off.
God, he must have been pretty keen to rent the flat. He's putting up with some extraordinary behaviour. Ooh, now, yes. This is interesting. Do you know if this comes? Is this part of the package?
I can't remember whether it comes furnished, but I can check that.
Can you?
Yeah.
Can you? That would be really good to know actually, because yes, this might be quite nice to just, you know, a bit of downtime, have a little sit down, just a little rest.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That could be good. In fact, you know what, Adam? My initial thought, I guess, obviously, was the bedroom, but just thinking it through now, we could do the sex stuff here.
Yeah. Yep, I think we could.
Do you know what I mean? I think that could work really, really nicely, actually.
I think that feels good to
me. Do you know, Stuart, do you know if that's been done before?
I could ask them.
Could you? Could you ask them? Because it would be good to get a sense of what is and isn't possible.
I think you'd best do whatever you want on the sofa.
Yeah. Okay, great. You know, I think for the whole sex thing, it could be, yeah, I think it could be really, really nice.
Yeah, I'm feeling that as well. I'm with you.
Do you think that would look good?
They're actually really, really nice. They gave us a 6-month break clause, which was really kind of them. And you know, Enfield is a lovely, lovely chilled, relaxed area. So
It's $2,800 a month
per day.
Whether that is.
What's per day?
It'd be 2,800, yeah, divided by 30, I guess.
But you don't know?
I don't know, no, sorry. So it's 2,800 a month?
Yes. But sorry, we're after a day, right? So what's that?
Well, there'd be 2,800. I can.
What's it? What's
it'd be 90, it would be 93.3 recurring. But don't,
three.
Yeah. 28.
Recurring. Alex, I've got the day rate.
Okay, sorry, one day.
Yeah.
I've got the, yeah, it's actually pretty good. So the day rate to get the whole place, 93.3 recurring.
It's 2,800 a month.
Okay. Yeah. So the day rate is what?
Yeah, this guy's just been asking me what the day rate is. So
be, yeah, it's 93.3.
Yeah, we'd
be even cheaper if you.
We need to know the day rate, yeah. So.
Okay, so it's 93.
Okay, 93.3 rockets, that is quite reasonable.
Yeah, but even cheaper if you wanted by the hour.
Do you do it by the hour?
It's per month, it's 2,800 a month is the rate.
I mean, £92 a day, I'd say, is pretty reasonable, but you see over a whole month, 6 months, you know, and including the deposit and bills and da da da, it does add up. So, you know, essentially, I guess that's how they get you.
Yeah, that's how they get you. With it being a completely normal rental agreement.
I mean, you know, the place is so big, there's two spare rooms, you know, so it feels like there's less of a kind of hostile environment to me just leaving my bedroom to
go out. Stop all this. Well, Anna, I just had an idea.
Go on.
Right, you know how we've got two spare rooms to rent out here? We also still need two actors for the film.
Yeah.
Right? We sublet the rooms here and put in the tenants' contracts that they have to be in the film. Oh. And that way, when we're showing people around, we're actually secretly auditioning them. We just choose the best actors.
Oh my God, that's great. Yeah. That's a really good idea. Yeah, great. Brilliant.
Sorry, it is a good idea. It's quite a weird idea though, isn't it? So I just wonder if for the sake of the behind the scenes, we should actually, do you mind guys, if we just get that again and just maybe at the end of me explaining the idea, instead of being on board with it, you kind of go, "Ooh, what do you mean?" And then I'll talk it through again so the viewer kind of definitely understands.
Wait, so you're going to come in and say the idea?
Yes.
And then I say, "What do you mean?" as though I don't understand it.
Yes.
And then you explain how, because we've got two spare bedrooms and we need two actors, we're going to advertise to sublet the rooms, show the people around them, pick the best actors, and sneak into their lettings contract that they have to be in the film.
Yeah, we actually got that now, haven't we? If you filmed that, we've done that twice. Perfect. Nice one.
Thanks.
Hey, hi. Molly.
Hello.
Hi.
Come in. Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. Hi, Alex.
Hi.
Ah, fantastic. Did you have an all right journey?
Oh, yeah. No, I just walked here. I work around the corner.
So. Oh, really? Oh, what kind of work do you do?
I'm a teacher.
Teaching?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a kind of performing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. Sorry, one second. Adam?
Yeah.
Hey, man, do you mind if we just take a quick... Just a picture. We're just doing a photo. Do you mind that? We're doing a picture of all the...
just for everyone. Sorry, do you mind if I take a... Do you mind if I take a photo?
No, go for it.
Great. Yeah. Profile as well. Yeah, yeah.
Do you mind just facing the staircase?
Yeah.
Brilliant,
yeah.
Thank you. Is it right if we do this? Great, thank you. And do you want...
No, it's okay. No, that's fine. Great. Okay, fantastic. Come in. Sit down. Yeah, yeah. Brilliant. And, feel free to... walk down the stairs as if you're arriving at your uncle's funeral.
What? Why?
Yeah. So, how did you hear about this room we've got going?
Just through my agent, basically.
Cool. You've got an agent.
It's Winkworth, the estate agent.
Oh right, yeah. No, yeah, sure. Oh, still pretty cool. Okay, so this is the tenancy agreement. If you'd just like to just give that a read.
Yeah.
In your own time. So yeah, maybe even just read it out loud.
Yeah.
Yeah, up for that, yeah.
This document is important. It sets out the rights and responsibilities of tenants and landlords under the agreement. Okay, so legally I have to, from the beginning, just read it all out?
Oh, God, yeah, absolutely. Is that all right?
I've never okay.
No, it's new anti-money laundering regulations, I think.
Right.
It should be kept for
great.
A lifetime.
Sorry to interrupt, just really good. I mean, just like even throw it, like just underplay even more, just really subtle, I think. Just try it.
Really subtle. The document contains some guidance notes on particular clauses. All adults living at the property as their only or main home have right to rent.
Sorry, Claire, just now that we're doing, because we all have to do this, why not let's have fun with it? Do you know what I mean?
What do you mean?
Just enjoy it. I don't know, maybe for example, try reading it in the style of a pilot who's announcing to their passengers that there's actually a serious safety issue on board. What if, like, fixed term, what if that was the really important thing? What if you were just to...
I'm kind of panicked or something. No.
Well, you're the pilot, so there's a sense of control.
This is an agreement for letting a dwelling on a fixed term, assured short-hold tenancy under Part 1 of the Housing Act 1980.
Someone comes in with a machine gun and goes, get on the floor, this is a robbery, no?
No.
I'll give you the big room if you do, though.
Brackets. As amended, close brackets. Actors are expected
Don't worry about the last page. That's, don't worry about that. Fantastic, really good, thanks Molly. Guy comes in with the gun, get on the floor now, and you continue in...
And I'm still, am I French? Is he French?
You're French, but you
I'm
spent
scared.
The last 5 years in Australia.
Okay, so,
One more thing, Molly, before we finish. Just whenever you're ready, name a nation.
No, don't worry.
We don't need
anymore.
Yeah, that is done. Okay, brilliant. Perfect. No more questions.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And here.
Yeah.
And here. Ah, brilliant, Claire. That's all done. Thanks. And we'll see you on the 14th.
On the 20th. I thought it was moving on the 20th.
Yep. Yeah. You're moving in on the 20th, yeah. But we're filming Petrichor on the 14th.
So, what did you say? Petrichor?
Yeah, Petrichor.
What's
bins collected on a Wednesday morning. Mm-hmm. The rent's due the first of the month. Mm-hmm. By signing, you're committing to 4 days filming to being our short film, Petrichor. Mm-hmm.
And you're going to fix the towel rail upstairs.
No. By signing the contract, the tenant commits to 4 days filming in the short film Petrichor.
Short film Petrichor? No.
Yeah, do you not remember? No. I know what's happened. When you read this bit of the contract out in the other room, you were doing it in the accent of Sean Connery.
So just to be absolutely clear, so you're happy to be in our short film Petrichor?
Yeah, I don't really care about the film or the cameras or anything. I'm just making sure that the tower rail's going to be fixed.
Oh, yeah, that's easy. Oh, wait. Okay, great. Well, yeah. Well, if you, then sign an initial there. And sign initial there, and sign initial there.
Well, I mean, I guess if I'm legally bound, I'd have to do it, but...
Great, fantastic news, excellent. Well, we will see you on the 14th.
why don't you tell me about the short film?
Hi guys, hey, sorry to bother you this late. Just to say we've actually pushed filming back a few days, just some like minor cash flow issues. The towel rail is costing a bit more to fix than we thought it would, which is kind of, you know, weirdly holding things up. Oh, and we are being sued by Help for Heroes. But, silver lining, this is all potentially fantastic texture for the behind the scenes doc. I mean, at this point, the audience is gonna be watching thinking, well, it really, really does seem like they're not gonna make this film. And then bang, that's where we hit them with the big payoff. obviously, we don't have that payoff now. We haven't got that footage. But, you know, maybe you guys come back in 6 months, 8 months, and me and Adam are at some glitzy award ceremony or something. You know, we're sitting there in our black tie. I'm fastening his little dicky bow. We cut to the stage. They slowly open an envelope and utter the immortal words. The award goes to Petrichor. That one, by the way, it turns out it's actually pronounced Petrichor, not Petrichor. So I have been saying that wrong for scores on the doors, 4 weeks, 5 weeks. So easy get around for that. I'll just say it quickly now, give you just a few options, and then you can lift those out and sort of dub them over me every time I've said it wrong so far. So, okay, here we go. Petrichor. 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 Thank you so much for supporting my film, Petrichor. I'm basically looking for memorable moments throughout Petrichor. A huge congratulations to Peter Lines for winning the Petrichor half marathon. Streamlining the writer's room was just a huge step forward for Petrichor. Huge thanks to Richard Parker for buying 8 mosaics and making Petrichor possible. It's been an absolutely fab day of auditions for Petrichor. I don't know how I'm going to choose between them. When it comes to sound, when it comes to Petrichor, you simply cannot cut corners. We've secured just the perfect Enfield-based location for Petrichor at a really competitive day rate. Team Petrichor offers a warm and legally binding welcome to Claire and Molly. It's been a bumpy road, but it's fair to say that things are well on track for Petrichor.